Hey there, you Daniacs. It's Zach and Gus. We're back from GreatDaneCare.com. Today, we're here to talk to you about the five reasons why we don't feed our Great Danes rawhides anymore. Now, to be completely upfront, I'm not a veterinarian. I don't have any medical expertise per se in this area. I'm just sharing my own personal experience of what I've seen with Great Dane and our other dogs having eaten rawhides in the past and the kind of outcomes that we saw from that. Now, I also don't really like it at all when videos get very preachy and say things like thou shalt not eat rawhides or go crazy and get wild in that regard. So I'm just gonna simply talk through the five reasons why we don't feed our dogs rawhides anymore. Now, before we get into those five reasons, I do have one quick thing to mention, and that's that we want you, all of you, to go ahead and vote with the comments as to what video you would like to hear from us next. Now in the comments, go ahead and vote for option one, which is how to get a beautiful shiny coat on your Great Dane, or option two, would you like to see a really in-depth tutorial about how we keep our Great Dane's ears sparkly clean. Now with that, let's jump into reason one here as to why we don't feed our Great Danes rawhides anymore. And that first and foremost is just the risk of intestinal blockages. The ability for a dog to tear off a big hunk of this and accidentally swallow it and have it get stuck in their throat or somewhere in their intestines is a big risk, and not only could that cause harm to them, it would also be a very expensive outcome if you had to take them to a veterinarian or a surgeon to have those pieces removed. Now, also knowing that our Great Danes, especially as they get larger, have very big mouths, whether they're tearing off a piece or swallowing the entire rawhide whole, it's just a risk that we didn't want to run into anymore. This won't be the truth for every case, but with Gus here, she actually would take our whole rawhide, and if she thought that we were going to take it away from her, she would just try to kind of kick it back and swallow the whole thing entirely as is. So after we saw her do this once, we literally put our foot down at that point and said we didn't want to get into rawhides anymore. Now before this happened, however, this different swallowing incidents, the other thing that we also noticed is that oftentimes after she would chew on a rawhide for a couple hours, that a few hours after that or even the next day, she would often have different bouts of diarrhea. Now, we already know the Great Danes have sensitive stomachs. Cases of diarrhea are already common. However, it seemed like literally every single time that she would chew on a rawhide, she was having diarrhea and other issues. So this is a pretty clear indicator that there's something going on with the rawhides that weren't sitting well with her stomach. And this caused me to actually start researching to find out, you know, what was the actual cause of this issue. The thing that I learned is that the kind of processing of these quote unquote rawhides is actually incredibly in depth. They take the rawhide and they apply different chemicals and processing to separate the different layers, to remove different bits of fat and other material from it. And then furthermore, they'll apply different chemicals as well to help make it appear whiter or make it more chewy for the dog so that they enjoy it more as well. Now what happens as these rawhides go through all these different processing steps is the company, of course, will take different measures to try to remove them from the rawhides. But in many cases, there's often residual chemicals being left behind. Now, if you don't think this is likely, let me give you a few examples of different chemicals that were actually found on rawhides after they'd been shipped and sent to the store. These chemicals include bleach, arsenic, lye, mercury. These are all incredibly poisonous materials, and while there may not be one big bolus that's sent to your dog all at once, this is quite literally the equivalent of giving them a slow dose of poisoning where they're just kind of slowly eating bit by bit. Now, of course, not every rawhide will have this. I'm sure that some companies do a better job of cleaning and removing these chemicals than others, but that really begs a separate question, and that's that the FDA, when they look at rawhides, they don't consider them food. And because of that, that means that they don't go through the same set of strict guidelines for testing and manufacturing that would be applied to actual food. So whether this is, not to say I want to put the blame on the rawhide companies, but because they receive less scrutiny, it does open the chances of having these residual chemicals being left on the rawhides, and in turn making our Great Danes sick. Now the next reason that we choose to not feed our Great Danes rawhides anymore is just simply the added calories. If you look at a rawhide, it's a very high fat content thing for them to eat and digest, and because they're not getting many other micronutrients from it, you're really just giving them an extra bolus of calories that could lead to issues with weight gain or weight management that really just isn't well placed. If your dog is hungry and they need more calories, they would be much better served by getting a more nutrient-rich source of food that actually provides not just fat, but maybe protein or carbohydrates or other types of micronutrients as well that would help benefit them in the long run. Now, the last reason that I don't like rawhides, and maybe this is just a personal issue because I feel like I was oversold or tricked by some marketing guru in the dog industry, is just simply the way that they named these. Clearly, they are called rawhides. Neither of those words of which are true. Clearly they're not raw because they've gone through such an in-depth processing to separate the different layers of the hide and remove different materials and then process it to make it look whiter. That's as far as it can possibly get from being raw. And the second piece of this is they're often referred to as a rawhide bone, clearly also for which they are not a bone. There is nothing bone-like about these. This is just simply skin that has been scraped down and cleaned and then twisted into some odd shape, be it a braid or some bone-looking thing, to look like a bone, for which it's very clearly not. All right, so now that you've heard the different reasons as to why I don't like rawhides, I think it probably begs the next equally good question is then, okay, what do we feed them now? Rawhides are a great way to entertain your Great Dane, give them something to chew on, maybe release some of that pent-up energy or that puppy excitement, right? So it would be unwise to just simply remove that and not replace it with something that is kind of better. A great alternative that I think a lot of people are shy away from or might be a little bit afraid of is that instead of giving them a rawhide bone, you should consider giving them an actual raw bone. Now, by comparison, raw bones are actually a tasty, safe, an unprocessed treat that will actually help your dog's teeth get clean in the process. So it does have a lot of benefits just from that front. But also consider the fact that because these are raw bones, they are much softer, which means your dog actually has the ability to chew on them and break down the components for which their body can then actually digest. And from these different components, their body can also derive different nutrients that are also beneficial in the long run. So it's not just a matter of helping them clean their teeth or giving them something to chew on. They can also get a net benefit out of the micronutrients that they get from these raw bones as well. Now, a couple key things to point out with raw bones is that obviously size still needs to be taken into consideration. Whether you have a Great Dane puppy or a full-blown Great Dane like us here, you want to ensure that you're not giving your dog these tiny little pieces of raw bones that they could very easily swallow and get stuck in their esophagus or cause all their blockages in their intestines. You still want to give them an appropriately sized bone to help prevent that from occurring. The other key thing to consider with a raw bone compared to a cooked variety bone is just the chance of bacterial exposure. Knowing that we don't want to have these just laying around the house and letting bacteria grow on them, the best approach is to kind of get a fresh one from the store and give it to your dog and let them chew on it for maybe an hour or two. And then after that, just go ahead and throw them out. While it may seem a little bit wasteful, most dogs love raw bones and will chew them very thoroughly for that hour or two that you give them to them, and there probably won't be a whole lot left at the end of it. In many cases, these raw bones are also very cheap, something you can easily get from your butcher at the local grocery store as well. Now with that, don't forget to go ahead and vote in the comments for which video you want to hear about next. Option one, once again, was how to get a shiny coat for your Great Dane. And option two was an in-depth ear cleaning tutorial. Also, if you're not subscribed to the channel, make sure to go ahead and do so now so you don't miss out on any of our future videos. And until next time, stay Daney, my friends.